This is a simulation of the field bet in craps. If you watch my other videos, I analyzed the best bets in craps, namely the pass line and the don't pass, and taking the odds and laying the odds. So this simulation shows one of the less favorable bets for the player, the field bet. The field bet pays 1-to-1 when you throw a 3, 4, 9, 10, or 11. If you throw a 2, it pays double your bet. If you throw a 12, you get triple your bet. And if you throw 5, 6, 7, or 8, you lose your bet. The field bet looks attractive because there's so many ways to win. And just four different numbers that lose. Of course, these numbers are the ones that are thrown the most often. So the house edge on the field bet is 1/36th, or 2.78%, about twice as much as for the pass or the don't pass. So each time I press the F9 key, I show the results of 400 field bets at $5 per bet. This blue line is the average trend line, that is the average result. At the end of 400 field bets, you on the average lose 11 bets, or about $55. So can you win with the field bet? Certainly you can win. But on average, you're going to be equal, there will be an equal chance of being above or below this blue line. Here's a nice session. You start with a bankroll of 300 and win $75 or so. And here's one not so good. You lose about $180, $190 here. Well, there's a nice session, winning more than $200. And of course, you get things in the opposite direction. Each button press is 400 field bets. There's a $200 loss. Now, some casinos, the less generous ones, pay only double, not triple, when you throw a 12. I'll put a 2 there instead of a 3. And so the house edge in that case is 2/36th, or 5.56%. And that will have a different trend line, which I'll display. Let's see. I'll do select data, and I've prepared this already. If you only get 2x on 12, this is the trend line for the less favorable payoff. So when I press F9, I get an additional 400 bets and an equal chance of being above or below this red dashed line. Oh, there's a bad one. Lost the whole bankroll in 300 some field bets. And you get some very lucky ones as well. Another bad one. Lost the whole bankroll. Come on, let's have some good ones. But you can see there was one. But you can see you're even less likely to have a winning session with this lower trend line. There's one casino in the United States that pays 3x on both the 2 and the 12. The house edge on that bet at this very generous casino is 0. Zero house edge. You're equally likely to win or lose. Let me open up that trend line, select data, fair game. And here we have a fair game. It's just as likely to be above the green line as below. In other words, an equal chance of winning or losing. So the moral of the story is, if you want to play craps, play the pass or don't pass bet, which has a trend line that runs halfway between the green one and the blue one, ends up here. And then taking the odds and laying the odds has a zero house edge like this dashed green line. Now, if you're interested in seeing how to set up this spreadsheet, I'm going to show that in the rest of the video. If you're not interested, you can leave now. Okay, so this is how I set up the spreadsheet. I'm going to move this down and move the whole spreadsheet so you can see what's going on. So here I've got the bet size, which you can change at any time, say 10 or whatever you want. I put 5 because that's a typical low bet. This cell generates a random number, a whole random number between 1 and 6, and this one does the same thing. This cell is just the sum of this one and this one, the sum of the two cells to the left. These are the payoff sizes for each of the bets. The standard bet is twice on 2 and triple on 3. This cell has an expression that evaluates if the number here is, if the throw is 3, 4, 9, 10, or 11, it pays off the amount in cell A1, this cell, multiplied by this payoff value here. Similarly, this cell has the payoff. If the throw is 2, it pays this cell times this cell. Similarly, this one, if you throw a 3, it's this cell times this cell. And similarly for this one. So in each of these four columns, one of these numbers is going to have a value in it, and the others will always be 0. So this column has the wins, which is just the sum of these four values here. And the running total is simply the previous running total. This is your starting bankroll, plus your win for that throw. So, you know, 300 is 295 plus 5, and 295 is 300 plus minus 5, and so on. Let me move over here. This is just 5, 10, 15, 20 upwards. And this is those trend lines I was talking about. If the 12 pays off 3, your average loss is 1/36. And if the payoff is 2, the lousier payoff, the house edge is 2/36 or 1/18. This is just the size of your bankroll all the way down straight. And so you graph these lines, graph the data in these lines to get those trend lines. You graph this running total to get the results. And that's how you set this up. Now I've put all these formulas in the description below the video, so you can get the information there. Okay, good luck.